And we're back. And we're now going to go after these guys. These guys are Grimlocks. They also have a magic attack, but it's pretty weak compared to the one... they just use a needle, so it's... Yeah, it's not gonna hurt us very much. It's still better, of course, not to get hit, but... 150, 200 damage points. Currently, that's not gonna do us... that's not gonna bother us too much. Our maximum hit points right now is, I think, 29,000, so... 100, yeah, we can spare that. Now, the experience for these guys is obviously a lot better than in previous levels, so... 100 experience for each kill, that's gonna get us quite a lot quite quickly. Okay, so we're up to 7,400 already. I'm going to look for a second beholder. And some more Grimlocks maybe, and anything else that will get us over 10,000 gold, because 10,000 gold is our goal right now. These lizardmen I'm going to leave alone because they're pretty strong. I happen to know the beholder lives all the way up here. And yeah, you know what, we'll take out these guys as well, because these guys, if I'm not mistaken, they drop 50 gold for each box in the first spawn. Yep, 50. So it's not a huge amount, but still 300 gold, can't hurt to pick it up. Especially because they're pretty easy, they don't do a lot of damage, and they're pretty slow, so... May as well get them out of the way. I think we even have enough wizard experience for another level, but I'll see in a second. There's the beholder again. Now again, just like before, you want to attack it from above, not from the left or the right. So I'm going to hopefully have it follow me here, yep. And then attack it from the bottom. Get out of the way as quickly as possible. And use my deck midar to clean him up. Again, the first spawn, not too interesting, just a little bit of gold. But the second and third spawns will be very nice for us. And they will get us very close to our 10,000 gold mark. After that, I'll just kill another couple of creatures randomly. Oh, here we go. Hopefully it'll follow us again. Yep. Oops, I let it hit me again. How annoying. And I think that might even hit me again because they are in fact able to shoot around corners occasionally. I think I killed... Yeah, I killed the guy who shot it, so he won't be able to control it anymore. Oh, but I stupidly walked right into another one. That's going to be a bit of a problem. I'm down to 500 hit points. Because, like I said, I kind of stupidly ran into one of them. And let it hit me two or three times in a row. So one more hit will kill us at this stage. Now, I can either take a chance... and attack the last guy, or I can get healed up and delay our upgrade quite a bit. You know what, I'm just gonna take the chance. If it doesn't work, I'll reload. Yep, here it is. Quite a lot of them too, so financially this is going to be pretty nice for us. Hopefully they won't kill me. This guy actually might. Thankfully, that wasn't going to happen. Yeah, looks like we got this. Thank God. Okay. Another 3,600, 900 gold. Now we'll just have to kill a few random creatures to get ourselves up to 10,000. I think I'll start by clearing out these Thunder Herders, because they're pretty weak too. And I happen to know that the second spawn of Thunder Herders drops poison, so I'm not gonna bother taking the item here either. If you remember the blue poison bottles, occasionally monsters will drop them as well, so... In the later levels, be very careful if you kill an unknown monster with your axe. You might actually... pick up some poison by mistake. Third spawn, I think, drops something useful, so I'm gonna try and kill these with my axe. you can see, even these relatively weak level 3 creatures will still do a couple hundred damage if they hit you. This one even did 500. So I might actually... Let me just see if I can time this properly. If you hit them from below or from the side when they're moving to in another direction, then they won't do any damage to you. So if you're careful, you can do this without taking any damage at all. But I'm a little bit lazy usually, so... But right now, they might actually kill me, so I'm going to be very, very careful. Yep, a red potion. Unfortunately, our wisdom is very low, so a red potion isn't going to do much for us. But I'll save him for later. Maybe we'll get our wisdom up at some point. Oh, these are gold ones too, so I can just use my mitar. That's nice. This will easily get us to our target. Yep. 120 each will easily clear 1,000 for us. Or 10,000 for us. Ideally, I'd get another 2,000 or so to afford a healer as well. But once we get our armor, that should be a lot easier to get. Oh yeah, the shopping area in level 3 is hidden behind this locked door as well. So, I guess we don't really have much choice. Except, of course, we could go back to level 1, but we're not going to do that. And you know what? I might want to take out these Grimlocks as well. Just for a little bit of extra gold. Our Mitar is already doing much more damage than our Needle ever was. It's already double what we got from our fully charged Needle. And our Mitar is only at... almost 60 experience, so yeah, Mitar is definitely a lot better than Needle. Even though it's only one step up from there. And of course the main reason we want to do this is for our deck attack. Let's see, okay, yeah, we were going to upgrade our armor, that's what we were doing here. So, let me show you first. If I now go into the armory and get a look at the armor that I really want, which is the half plate. It's still close to 15,000 gold, so we don't have enough. Now this is where our little trick comes in that I was talking about earlier. We'll equip item, bottle. We use the bottle and then we enter the store right away because our bottle is only going to last a little while because our wisdom, my wisdom currently is so low. So if I can just get these Grimlocks out of the way. Press enter and immediately press spacebar. Once you're in the armory, you have all the time in the world because your time doesn't run out when you're in a shop. So now we can buy the half plate and it's brought back to only 10,000 instead of 14.6 or something it was. So now we have enough to buy our half plate. Yes. Only 500 gold left, but it's really, really worth it. If you look at my statistics, currently my defense is only 562, which is from our reasonably experienced padded mail. If I now go onto the armor half plate, immediately we go up to 1600. So yeah, that's considerably better than what we had before. And we can even sell our old armor. Hey, wait a minute. Yeah, it even looks a little bit cooler on our guy. See, we have a black vest right now. If we equip armor half plate, he gets a little cross on his chest. Oh well. So yeah, we'll sell our studded mail. And we'll have a little bit of gold to play with now. Unfortunately, I don't think it's enough to heal. Almost, almost. We'll just kill one of those slugs and we'll have enough to get our health back as well. With our new armor, these slugs won't be able to touch us. So we can easily just kill them, just like this. I think they're not even strong enough to hit us from the side or from behind right now. So we can just kill these guys with impunity. I do have to be a little bit careful because I believe these guys are also poison droppers after the first round. Oh, but this is the first spawn, of course, so it's still the bottle. If I kill the second one, I think that's that one drops poison, which I might as well show you since our hit point is low anyway. A poison bottle will instantly halve your current hit points, whatever your current is. So if you have 10 hit points, you're down to 5. If you have 10,000 hit points, you're down to 5,000. There we go. Open. Oh, it's a red potion. get it one more time. It's either the third or the fourth then. I'm pretty sure one of them at least drops poison. There's a couple of more creatures in this level that drop poison, so you have to be pretty careful. Especially in later levels, poison is really the bane of your existence. If you have like 100,000 hit points, you don't want to lose half of them to a single stupid mistaken pickup. Oh, fire gem. Crystal. Then it must be the fourth that has the poison. I'll show you how that works. Since we're going to heal up anyway, it doesn't matter. Now you might have noticed that hits come up a lot more quickly with my melee weapon than before on level 2, just because I upgraded my agility pretty significantly. Okay, here we should see the poison bottle coming out. Yep, there it is. Poison bottles are dark blue and really terrible. If I walk into it, by moving to the right now, you'll see that my hit points drops from about 800 to about 400. There you go. Now these poison bottles actually do have a use, but not for us at the moment. So I'll explain about that later. We have enough gold to heal now, so let's do that, because honestly we need it. And we're back up to 29,000, which is very nice indeed. Oh, I forgot. Do I want to do that? I think we have enough experience for another wizard level, but I think we'll wait with that a little while, because we don't need it right now. And I think I want to... Well, like I was talking about earlier, leveling up means you use more food, stuff becomes more expensive, so I'm going to hold off on that until we need the extra level. Actually, I might be coming up on the time limit for this video already. So, I'm thinking I might have to cut it off here. I should have started the timer, but I forgot. There we go. These guys drop a ruby. That's always nice. So yeah, our armor is now up to a pretty good level. Our magic is reasonable. It's not great yet. I think that's going to be our next priority. But we should be able to take on just about any creature we run into now, except for the ones with really powerful magic, but we can always just use our dex spell to get rid of them. Actually, I kind of need a food store as well, because I'm running low on food. But you know what? I'll do that off screen. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll be back with the next video in a bit.